Great. So you're already familiar with Ansible and have a general idea of what it can do. Before we dive into using the tool, we just need to do a bit of prep work. The first step is to choose a device from which we'll manage our servers and infrastructure. Ideally, this device should be Linux-based and have network access to all the devices or computers we want to manage. Personally, I'm using a Raspberry Pi 4 with 4 GB of RAM, but you can use almost any device that's available to you. It could be an Orange Pi, Keras, Odroid, Udo, RockPi, your old laptop, or even a virtual machine running Ubuntu or Debian or another modern Linux distribution. Don't worry, whatever you have available will work just fine. Now let's talk about how to install Ansible. While you can install it through your system's repository with a command like sudo apt install ansible or sudo dnf install ansible, I don't recommend it. That method won't probably give you the latest stable version of Ansible. And there are some amazing features in the newer versions. Instead, I suggest installing Ansible via pip, the package installer for Python, to get the latest version. Assuming you have Python 3 and pip installed on your system, which is common in modern operating systems, installing Ansible is a breeze. If you need help installing Python and pip, check out the link in the video description for instructions. Let's jump into a terminal and I'll show you how it's done. So, to install Ansible, run this command. Python 3-m pip install user Ansible. This will install Ansible and its dependencies for your current Linux user. It's simple as that. If you ever want to upgrade it, run this command. Python 3-m pip install upgrade user Ansible. And just to be sure, verify if Ansible is installed correctly by running Ansible --version. It should display basic information about Ansible. I came across one thing that might be helpful to know. When I installed Ansible, the scripts were installed into directory home/.local/bin, which wasn't in my path. Path is where the system stores the paths to the scripts we use, so we don't have to write the full paths every time we want to use them. It would be annoying to have to call them like /home/py/.local/bin/ansible instead of just Ansible. So I had to add the directory to my path to use them seamlessly. Since I use zsh or zshell, I added this line to my home/.zshrc file. Notice that I added home local bin to it. If you're using bash or something else, you can easily find instructions on how to edit your path settings using Google or ChatGPT. By the way, I highly recommend trying out zshell with the oh-my-zsh plugin framework. It has made my life so much easier. Keep an eye out for my future videos. I'm sure I'll do a video on it soon. That's it, now you have Ansible installed and ready to use. I hope this video has been helpful to you. If so, please hit those like and subscribe buttons and join me in my next video. Bye!